Hello everyone, I, Assistant Professor Abhigna Vaishnav from LJ Integrated MBA, once again welcome you all to the video lecture series for the subject Advanced Marketing Management for Semester 5 Integrated MBA. Well, up till now, we've seen value chain analysis, strategic planning processes, marketing environment analysis, marketing information system, and marketing research. Now, after doing that, you should be able to learn how to forecast and measure the demand. Well, it is very important for any marketer to forecast the current level as well as the future level of demand and measure the same as well, so as to be clear about the resources that he possess. For that, the measurement scale that he has, there are at least 90 measurement scale that he has. If you see at the space level, at the product level, and at the time level, there are 90 sales created. The marketer can use these measurement scales. Now, if you see the definition of certain markets, what do you mean by market? Market means the actual plus the potential buyers of a product, available market, potential market, target market, and penetrated market. Well, potential market is when the customers show interest in your offering. That's a potential market. Available market means when the customers have the interest, desire, access, and income. Everything for your offering, that's an available market for you. Target market means the qualified, best suitable market that you can pursue, that's a target market. And penetrated market means the current consumers who are purchasing your products, that's a penetrated market for you. Now, if you see certain vocabulary for demand measurement, market demand, market forecast, market potential, first we'll see that. What do you mean by market demand? Market demand means the total number of customers or a total volume of the product bought by the customer group in a defined geographical area, in a defined time period, in a defined marketing environment, in a defined marketing program. That's a market demand. Then comes market forecast. Well, at a particular level, as the marketer expends something, incurs expenses, and at that particular level, the demand that he forecasts, that's a market forecast. And market potential is the upper limit of the market beyond which any amount of expenditure incurred would not lead to increase in demand. That's a market potential, the highest limit. Company demand, company sales forecast, and company sales potential. Company demand is company's percentage of market share in accordance with the company's income expenditure. Company sales forecast means it is the total amount of share that the company has in accordance with the marketing environment in a given marketing program. And company sales potential means it is in relative importance given to the competitors as well. The limit achieved by the company relative to the competitor's achievement in accordance with their marketing effort and expenditure. That's a company sales potential. Now, if you see market demand functions, well, if you can see, as I said, market forecast, market potential, market demand, the vocabulary that just we have seen. On one side, we have the same three figures on one marketing environment. We are assuming that the marketing environment remains the same. In the other part, here we are assuming two kinds of marketing environment, one with prosperity, one with recession. You can see the graph differs. The amount of expenditure that you incur in prosperity and the result that you get, it is totally different. That too in recession, when the amount of expenditure turns up the market demand. So you have to keep in mind the environment as well as far as forecasting of demand is concerned. Now we'll see estimating current demand. Total market potential. Well, how to measure that? The total market potential means the total number of buyers and the amount of volume that they buy. You can figure it out by using this formula. Potential buyers multiply by the average quantity purchased by them, multiply by the price of the product. Then comes the area market potential. You have to identify a specific territory within which you can identify the potential buyers using two methods. Market buildup, wherein you identify a territory, city, state, or a nation. Then you identify the potential customers and identify the amount of quantity purchased by them along with the price. Second method is multiple factor index, wherein you give weightage to the each criteria that the customer think before purchasing. Give weightages to each, thereby you can forecast the current demand. And the third method is industry sales and market share, wherein you can identify the products of the consumers that they bought from the competitors as well, and as well as your companies as well. Thereby you can identify the current demand of industry level as well. Then comes estimating future demand. Well, survey of buyer's intention, composite of sales force opinion. You can carry out these by asking certain questions to your staff, to your employees. They are the best person to give you the best estimate about the future demand. You can have experts, you can take the experts' opinion for future demand, because you are estimating future which is not clear. They know the situation better, you can take help of them as well. Past sales analysis, you have the records on hand, you can refer that as well. And if anything doesn't work out, you can definitely go for market test method. Try the method in the market itself, don't ask to anyone else, just rely on market and estimate the future demand. So as far as forecasting and measuring demand is concerned, this is the end of the chapter. We are done with the module 2. We'll see you in the module 3 in the coming series of video lectures. That just does it from my side. The references I've taken from the book Marketing Management by Kotler, Kevin, Koshi and Jha, the 11th and the 14th edition. That just does it from my side. Keep learning.